Good evening everyone, and welcome to the video. It is Tuesday evening, it'll obviously be Sunday morning by the time you're watching it, but as you can see from the title and thumbnail, this is a picking and packing video of all the orders that I've got this week. Welcome to the garage with new and improved lighting. So I've got two LED batons across the top. Before I just had a single bulb and it was like a yellow colour. These are nice and bright. I've also got my studio photography box on as well, just for some decent lighting. So yeah, we're going to get cracked on. Like I say, it's Tuesday evening. I've just come home from work and my wife has picked out some orders for me to pack. So there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in total, totaling £124.50. And this is from Sunday, so kind of Sunday afternoon, Monday and all of Tuesday. So I'm going to do snippets throughout the week. I'll probably do another one of these videos Thursday, or yeah, Thursday and Saturday maybe, compile it together, and that'll be what you're watching now. So we're going to get straight into it. First one in front of me here. Pardon me. If I can remember, I'll tell you what I bought it for and what it sold for. So first up is these pair of men's Timberland shoes. These would have come from Vinted for between £8 and £10. You know by now from previous videos that's what I spend on trainers. Anything decent on Vinted, I sort of filter the price to maximum about £12. Yeah, nice pair of Timberlands popped up. And I think, where are those shoes? I had them up for 20 and I took an offer of 15 just to move them along. Made a few quid on it, but there's not a massive amount of work involved and they're easy to post. So we'll use these mailers. So I've got all different sizes. These are the ones that you used to get for free from UPS. I think they've stopped doing it now because, Everyone found out about it and they were ordering loads, so we'll put them in there, seal that up. If you were a business and you used to be able to go on the UPS website and register, and you used to be able to get free bags and shipping labels and stuff. While I'm packing, I'll also, I don't know if I've talked about this before, but some packing essentials. Get yourself a tape gun. There's a few different types, but they all work in the same way. They all feed the tape through and have sort of a knife edge on it. Makes it a lot easier than trying to find the end of the tape every time. Go, and that one's done. So I don't need to write on it what it is, I'll remember what it is, but I usually, if it's in a box, I'll write on it what it is and then I'll go on the laptop and I'll print out all the labels and I can match up what's what. So we'll pop that down there. If I sound a bit funny, yesterday I had a wisdom tooth out, so I'm still recovering from that a bit, so I've just got to take it easy a little bit. So next up, we have this Wii remote, and it's got Motion Plus built in. I know some of them have the little thing at the bottom. I'm not quite sure on the different types, but this one's got it built in. I got a black one and a red one from a local charity shop for £4. So £2 each. I was always picking them up at that price. I've put batteries in, I've tested it, they work fine, and that has sold for 20, and I believe the red one's up for 20 as well. So I've got a little box. I reuse a lot of packaging, but I do buy boxes as well. I buy this size and I buy some a bit bigger. I think these are 8 inches by 6 by 3, I think. and the bigger ones that are by a 12 by 9 by 6, which is the maximum size for a Royal Mail small parcel, so quite handy. So my wife has prepared some packaging for me to help speed things up, and talking about reusing, newspaper is really good for void fill, so we'll put a bit of that in the bottom. Then we'll wrap the item up. I've tested it with batteries, but I don't send any batteries with it. You're not really meant to send batteries in the post. Wrap that up, a bit more newspaper in the top. Something I haven't been doing, I'll show you. Like you've seen before, I like to include these little feedback slips. Just reminds the customer that if they've had a good experience, then to leave feedback on my eBay store. So I'll pop one of them in and tape it up. And I'll write on that. Wii remote. When I do my labels, I know what it is. Everyone that's buying items at the moment also gets sent a coupon. Now I have these printed off as well. It's a bit dark, you can see it there. So it's a 10% off coupon for any future purchases. I've printed some off to include in with parcels, but all the customers automatically get sent a message after they placed an order anyway. But the coupon code is 2023XMAS10, and that gives you 10% off anything on my shop. The link to my eBay shop is down below, as well as loads of other links. Check them out, some referral links where you can earn some money and stuff like that. And this is valid until the end of the year, 31st of December. So worth doing. So moving on, what should we do next? We have got these Peroni hats. Now I'm guessing these were from a pub or something, you know, they get sent sort of novelty items when the football's on and things like that. So not a great deal of value, but I found these whilst dumpster diving, and they have sold for £10. I think I put them up for 15 for the pair. Someone offered £10 and I accepted it. And we're going to use one of the trusty UPS bags again, because they're not going to break, they're quite, you know, durable. Include one of the slips. Put them in there. Tape it up. Right, hats on the back. There we go, another one done. If you are enjoying the video so far, then don't forget, drop it a like and subscribe to my channel. There's all sorts of reselling content. Just remember, go back and look at my older videos as well. I try and do something different every week. Okay, the next one is a board game. It's a vintage cricket board game knockout. Yeah, I got this dumpster diving as well, and it's all complete. I've checked all the parts, and it's quite, I wouldn't say rare, but it's not common, if that makes sense. I got £20 for that game, so I think I put it on for £24.99. I accepted an offer of £20. I again, especially in the in Q4 in the run up to Christmas. I'm happy to move things along, accept offers. You know, I'm listing new items all the time, so I just want to keep it turning over, really. So I've got these big grey mailing bags. Can't remember the size, but it's like one of the largest ones you can get. And they're great for like jigsaws and board games like this. Put my slips in. There we go, it's easy as that. And again, I'll remember what that one is because, you know, because of the shape of it. We'll pop that down there. What have we got next? We've got three items left. We will do this one. So we've got a load of TY Beanie Bears. Now they're not worth a lot. People think, oh yeah, they're vintage and they're collectible, but they're really not worth too much. This is probably one of the ones that is worth looking out for if you're at a car boot, and they're 50p a pound each or so. This is a Princess Diana bear, and this is sold for £25. So usually they're only worth a few quid, but you do get rare ones now and again that are worth a bit more. And because it's sold for quite a bit, I'm going to put it in a little box. Yeah, so these are the small boxes I said before, 8x6x4. What we'll do, we'll put the bear in a bag as well. Just because I'm going to use newspaper as void fill, and it just prevents it getting dirty and stuff like that. Bit of newspaper in the bottom, teddy on top. Newspaper on top and the little feedback slip. There we go. We've got two orders left to do. We have got, I've got a bit of a fragile one, which I'll leave to the end. And I've got this, which is a vintage matchbox, like play mat thing. And it's of like a dockyard, so Sea Kings. Quite a nice thing. It's vintage, but I opened it up and it's in really good nick. Couldn't see that many on eBay again, so it was quite scarce. Not rare, but not common. I took an offer of £16.50 on that one. I think I probably had it listed for about £25. With that one, I'm thinking of doing something where I use a big mailer bag, but put a bit of cardboard on the back as protection. Excuse me. Right. Yeah, that'll work just right. We'll put the box in, put that in on top. I may as well be putting these coupon codes in, seeing as I've got them, along with the feedback slip. They do actually work as well, because when someone orders something, you can see that they're a repeat customer. So it is nice to see people coming back. And obviously, if you're selling a lot of the similar kind of product, then if it's something they collect or clothes they wear or something, they're more likely to come back because you're selling the kind of stuff they want. There we go, so it's got a big bit of cardboard to protect it. That was the matchbox. And the last one I've got are these, they're called Whimsies. So they're little ceramic animals made by Wade, who make a lot of sort of ceramics and a lot of the sort of ashtrays and tankards from pubs and things will have Wade on them. But I think there's about 17, 18 different animals. And again, I got these dumpster diving, so they didn't cost me anything. And I took an offer of £18 on them, so about £1 a piece. But I think I'm going to have to take them out of there and put a bit of bubble wrap in between them. Just to give them a bit of protection, stop them breaking. Reusing some bits of bubble wrap here from something else. So we'll just make some layers in this little box. Stop them moving about and hitting each other. If you're also a reseller, I assume if you're watching this that you are, but I think some people aren't, but they just enjoy the content. Let me know, how often do you post out during the week? For me personally, it's, I'd say, 3 times a week. And also, what do you have on your dispatch time on your listings? Mine's set at 2 working days. But if I can get it out sooner, then I will. It obviously depends if you're part-time, if you're full-time. But I found those settings work for me, and I can manage with that. So they're nice and secure in that little box. And then I've got a bigger box with some void filling. I'll put them in there, pack around it, and we shouldn't have any issues. Fingers crossed. Again, another good source for void fill is wallpaper. See rolls of wallpaper at car boots and charity shops for like £1 a piece. It's usually cheaper than buying rolls of void fill. There we go, that's our last parcel. Right, on it so I remember what it is. Put that down there. So that's everything that's sold the last couple of days. I'll be doing the same again, like I say, Thursday. So it tends to be like every other day. And then obviously at the weekend, I'll kind of post on Friday, and then not again till the following Monday. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I will see you later in the week. I have just packaged these up. This was an order from Vinted, so I've been buying things on Vinted, just having a look in the evenings for things, and I've been looking at model kits. Now it's coming up to Christmas, sort of aeroplanes, cars, model kits, things like that. So I bought these for £50, and there's two of them, and they stated they were brand new and sealed, complete, nothing wrong with them. I did my research and thought that's a really good price. Yeah, I'll buy them. And the thing is, they turned up and I opened them up and straight away they stunk of smoke, so I wasn't happy with them smelling of smoke, because they didn't state this in their listing. And then on closer inspection, they had both been opened. I opened the first one and it had actually been half built, and it had some pots of glue in there and stuff. I opened the second one and the box had been opened, but the packaging was sealed, but it all stunk of smoke and I really wasn't happy. So I contacted the seller and said, look, these smell of smoke. You stated they were brand new and sealed. They're not. One's been half built. And they weren't too bad about it. They did say, oh, we checked them and they are new. And I sort of had to send them photos. Oh, look, they're not new. So they don't hold as much value as I'd hoped. So it wasn't really worth me selling them, and I couldn't sell them stinking of smoke. So we come to the agreement that I'm returning them. So £50 plus some fees and postage, £55. So I've got a label. I just need to print my label, and that'll go with the rest of my parcels. But I just thought I'd explain to you, look out on Vinted, as good as it can be. You know, you can have issues, but I'd say the return process so far has been fairly good, because of how Vinted hold the money for the seller. They haven't had their money released, or my money released to them, until I'm 100% happy. So I need to get this sent back in the next couple of days, and then I'll get my money back. So happy days. And there's my return label. Hello everyone, I am back. It is Friday now, and I have got some orders to pick and pack. So looking at the laptop, I have got 7 in total since Wednesday, so they are all stored in my sort of SKU system here. And then down here, excuse the massive amount of packaging, and then on the rack in here, this stuff's unlisted, this is all listed, that's listed, and my sort of media shelf there. So yeah, let's get it all picked. So I am really annoyed with myself, because I set my camera up on my tripod. I had my microphone plugged in and forgot to turn my microphone on. So I did 10 minutes of picking all these orders and explaining everything, and it's ruined because there's no audio. So I probably won't do that again. I've learnt my lesson. But here we go. Everything's picked out. I'm going to go through with you what I paid, what it sold for, and talk a bit about each item. So the first thing that sold was this replacement mobility scooter wheel. Nothing special, it's not new, but it's in good nick. That sold for £11.99 and didn't cost me anything. The next sale is this remote control for a Sharp Aquos TV. Now, it's really important to hang on to accessories and things like this, because they do sell. Same for sort of power adapters and chargers for video consoles, remotes for TVs and things like that. That sold for £6.99. So, yeah, that's all right. All accessories are worth something. So just because the item itself is broken, you still get some of your money back with the accessories. Next up, we have another ashtray. I'm sure you've seen these by now. If you haven't seen the car boot video, go onto my channel, watch my car boot videos, and you'll see I picked up about 15 of these for 50 pence each, and these are selling steady for £6.99. So after fees, you're sort of making £5 a piece. So happy days with them. This item is a Mo Farah print signed. Nothing special, didn't cost me anything. It sold for £5. It's just a little item that gets some feedback into the store. Moving on, I picked up a big bundle of vintage Harry Potter items. Again, I did a video on it, so if you haven't seen that yet, be sure to go to my channel, watch the video, give it a like if you enjoyed it. But these were part of the bundle. They owe me about £1 a piece, and I took an offer of £12 for the three. Had them up for 15. Took an offer to move them along. So we've got two items left. This is a aromatherapy diffuser kind of thing, getting quite popular at the moment. But you will see in my last video that I sold some of the oils. This is the machine itself that they're for. I had this listed for 120 and it sold on offer for £100, so that's okay. And another item that you would have seen in videos was from my car boot video. I picked up three of these pieces of audio equipment. I think they're like for DJs or sort of sound engineers. I picked up three and I paid a total of £90, so £30 a piece. I had two that were new, one that was used. The two new ones have sold to the same person for about £260. And this one has just sold the other day for £84.99. So I'm happy with that. £90 investment, bringing back about £350 before fees. So yeah, I'm going to get all this packaged up. I'm going to set you back up on the shelf. Remember to turn my microphone on this time or see if it's charged up. If not, we'll do it without. The video I did that you've just seen on Wednesday, I did without. So I hope it's okay. But yeah, let's get straight into it. So let's get into packaging. I'm not going to bother with my microphone because it needs charging and stuff. So I just had to shout, but I've had a listen back and the volume sounds all right. So I have prepared some packaging bits. I'll just talk you through it. Harry Potter jigsaws, nice and easy, straight in a jiffy bag. These are size D. These are really good for DVDs, video games, things like that. And they're about, depending how many you buy and where you buy them from, between 10 and 20p a piece. Nice and easy one. I'll grab a Sharpie. Write on it what it is. I've got my return label on my vintage parcel that you've just seen. Yeah, I've got a ton of packaging materials here which I got for free off Facebook Marketplace. So it's a bit hard to move, but I need to have a sort out of my packaging. I need to have a sort out of the rafters up the top of the garage. See if I can get some of it bagged up and put away. And then I've got a good supply. So next up is the remote, which I'm just going to put in one of these boxes, which I've talked about before. Again, I think they're about £25 for 100 or something like that. So 20p or something. Some of the packaging that I got for free was a lot of this shredded cardboard, which is really handy. So I'm going to cut a bit of this off. It's probably easier to rip it actually. Just going to wrap the remote in some of that as a bit of void fill. Pop it in the box. That's not moving about. general rule, if it doesn't move about, then it can't get broken. Depends on your courier. Tape that up. TV remote. Nice and easy. A lot of these orders are nice, quick and easy to package. None of it's massively breakable. A lot of it goes in a box or an envelope, you know. Like another one that's quick and easy, the Mofara print. So I've talked about before in the other clip, the UPS packaging. I used to be able to get these do not bend envelopes. But you can buy these in A4, A5 and A6 as well, which I've got a load of different sizes because they are handy. But I will put that in one of these. And that's it, easy as that. Don't need to write on it, I know what it is. I like to be like methodical, like do a load of packaging, do a load of labels. Some people will package one thing, sit on the computer, print the label, but I find it quicker just to churn it all out and then sit down and do all the labels. But it's whatever works for you. It depends how many orders you've got, the scale of your business, things like that. Put the rubbish away, stay nice and tidy. So I've got a load of these boxes as well, which are these ones stacked up here. I got all these for free. I actually got these dumpster diving. So there's a bit of a industrial estate local to me, and there's like a local sort of gin distillery or something, I think it was, because they had rolls of their labels in their bin. But they had bundles and bundles of these boxes in there, like literally at one of these commercial bins full of brand new boxes. And I literally just filled my car. They were in the recycling bin, so they were getting recycled, but they must have just been the wrong size for them now or something. But I don't know, it just seems criminal to me throwing that kind of stuff out. They could have even offered them on Facebook for free or something, because they're actually paying the bin company to take their waste away. So yeah, but some people don't think about it like that. So I'm going to use that for the wheel again. I'm going to put some of this in the bottom. I'm going to wrap it in some of this, because I've got a lot of shredded paper, I've got a lot of corrugated card, which are them rolls there. I've got boxes of bubble wrap, boxes of brown paper, and a load of flat pack boxes down here. So I'll probably put them flat pack boxes up the top and try and organise the things a bit better. But yeah, anytime I see free packaging on Facebook, I'm there picking it up, because you can never have too much, because like there'll be periods where you use a lot of it and you run out, so it's nice to have a lot of it. Tell you what I haven't been doing, I haven't been putting my little slips in. I forget all the time. I'll put one in there. That's the wheel. I'll package that up. And even though it's the evening time, I'm going to take all this stuff to the parcel shop tonight, just because we're heading that way to do a bit of a food shop. So I like to try and always do it while I'm doing something else. So none of it will go till tomorrow, but I don't have a reason to go out tomorrow. So it saves journeys. There we go, that's the wheel in there. If you are enjoying this kind of video, It's probably boring to some people. I did a picking and packing video before and it was an hour long and it's not had that many views. So if you do enjoy this, please check it out and drop it a like. But yeah, I just try to do varied content, show you how I package stuff to give you an insight if you're just starting out. Gives you some ideas of the sort of supplies you need to buy, and look out on Facebook and things like that for free packaging. We'll do the ashtray. I need to see if I've got something suitable for that. Which I think I'll use another one of these square boxes and just sort of cut it down. I've got some ideas for videos lined up, sort of for sourcing stock over the winter and things like that. Obviously car boots are finishing. And you need to think of some different ways to source some stock. So you've always got sort of Facebook Marketplace, but it's a bit unreliable. So I've reached out to a local house clearance firm who sort of, you know, clear people's houses and send the stuff to auction, or they sell it at car boots and things like that. So I've reached out to them, told them what I do, told them I'm interested in turning up once a week, once a fortnight or something, filling my car. They told me the kind of stuff they get and it's the kind of stuff I'm interested in buying. So I probably don't need to cut this box down. I've just put a lot of padding in, so we'll leave it. Put my feedback slip in. Was the ashtray. See, they are all quick. This video has been going 10 minutes and I've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 orders nice and quick. The next one is this diffuser. So it's already in its own box, so I'll just find a box a bit bigger than the item, fill it with void fill so it can't move about. Give it some protection. I'm going to see what I've got. I've got this one. That'll be perfect. Also, you want to be finding supermarkets, local shops. I think a lot of people get boxes from like McDonald's and stuff like that. Especially the bigger ones. Because if you were to buy brand new boxes this size, it would literally cost you a fortune. So we'll tape the bottom of that up. I know you can't really see what I'm doing, so I'm trying to explain it. I've just filled the bottom there with some padding. I need to try and find a better sort of camera angle, like I need to put it on a sort of wide zoom and have it up in the corner or something so you can literally see everywhere. Put the item in, fill around the edge basically. There we go, filled it with shredded paper, it's well protected, put a slip on, and we'll tape that up. there we go. There's the aromatherapy machine. I'm sure that might be someone's Christmas present. So we want to make sure it gets there safely. And the very last item I have is the audio equipment. Again, it's got its own box, but I'm just debating whether to... I didn't actually advertise it in this box because I forgot I had it. I just sort of photographed the item itself. So I might just wrap this in bubble wrap, put it back in this box and use this for posting. Because this is what it originally came in, it's quite a solid box. So we'll do a few layers of bubble wrap. Like that. Some of the bubble wrap I got for free is sort of this big bubble stuff, which is really handy. I buy rolls. They are 500 mil wide by 100 meters long, and they're about 10 to 12 pound. That fits nicely back in there. Put the instructions back in. Put a feedback slip in. And then I've just filled the top there with a bit more. So there won't be anything wrong with that. Make sure it's all secure. We don't want any accidents for the sake of the cost of the tape. We know what some of the couriers are like. There we go, done. That's not moving about. That's safe as anything. So there we go, short and snappy, 16 minutes long. 7 orders packed. They were nice, quick, easy things to pack. That's the end of the video. So that's everything that's sold this week. I hope you've enjoyed it. Like I said before, if you enjoy this kind of video, look back on my channel and I've done an hour long picking and packing video, as well as some of the items you've seen here feature in car boot videos, and obviously the Harry Potter video as well. So give all of them a watch. If you enjoy this kind of reselling content, follow me on my journey. Like I say, my subscribers are growing, so that's really good. Share my channel on Instagram and everything. George's Treasure Shed on Instagram. I'm quite active on there as well, posting updates on what I'm buying, what I'm selling, things like that. I also post on there every time new videos are out. So it tends to be every Sunday at 9 a.m. So check it out. All sorts of different content every week. If you have enjoyed the video, remember to subscribe and like the video on your way out. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye now.